It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is consideration of business motion 1143 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, setting out a change to this week's business. Any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and formally moved.
Thank you. No member has asked to speak against the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 1143 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 1111 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Once again, Presiding Officer, moved.
The question is that motion 1111 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 1112 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on stage one timetable for a bill. Any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Moved, Presiding Officer.
No member has asked to speak against the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 1112 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The next item of business is consideration of 9 Parliamentary Bureau motions. And I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move motions 1113, 1114, 1115 and 1117 to 1120 on approval of SSIs, 1121 on committee membership and 1122 on committee substitutions.
Moved, Presiding Officer. I'm quite happy to go into detail on the SSIs if you wish.
Minister, if you would wish to, but we
not
don't.
That I would prefer to wish to, but just I was giving you the option.
I think, Minister, given that you have offered the chamber that option,
yes,
you should continue.
Let's hear you, George.
Yes.
Let's hear you.
Once again, Presiding Officer, everyone's favourite time of the evening. The first SSI is the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Amendment Number 13. Regulations 2021 SSI 2021-237 came into force on the 14th of June and has extended to the definitions for elite sport to include all events at which specified persons compete to qualify for the Birmingham Commonwealth Games. The next one is Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment Number 27, Regulations 2021, SSI 2021-238, came into force on the 11th of June. It included providing a person designated by a local authority with a power of entry to enforce restrictions relating to stadia and events. And the next one is the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment Number 28, Regulations 2021 SSI 2021-242, came into force on the 18th of June. It included removing Ireland and Bedford Borough Council from the list of areas to which common travel area restrictions apply. Following that is the Health Protection Coronavirus Restriction Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment Number 29. Regulations 2021 SSI 2021-252 came into force on the 26th of June. It included adjusting physical distance requirements in various settings, including funerals. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment Number 30, Regulations 2021 SSI 2021-255, came into force on the 30th of June. It included removing the areas of Bolton Metropolitan Borough Council from the list of areas of which common travel area restrictions apply. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment Number 31, Regulations 2021, SSI 2021-262, came into force on the 8th of July. It included reducing required physical distances to maintain between persons within the premises of the Renaissance Club, North Berwick, for a period of the Scottish Open in July. The Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 32, Regulations 2021, SSI 2021-263, came into force on the 19th of July and include reduced physical distancing to 1 metre indoors and outdoors. And finally, Presiding Officer, the Health Protection Coronavirus Requirement Scotland Regulation 2021, SSI 2021-277, came into force on the 9th of August. It included the requirement for relevant hospitality and entertainment premises to obtain a record visitor information. And that is that, Presiding Officer.
Oh, heavens.
Thank you. Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. There are three questions to be put as a result. Point of order, Neil Bibby.
This afternoon, the First Minister accused a number of members of this chamber of using data on Test and Protect in a misleading manner. She accused members of talking down the performance of Test and Protect and proceeded to share her wisdom with the chamber on the accuracy of provisional figures. The First Minister, then using provisional figures, appeared to suggest performance was within the WHO standards. It's a case of do as I say, not as I do, Presiding Officer. And it gives a misleading impression of Test and Protect performance by the test the First Minister herself set for others. The First Minister was given the opportunity to clarify her remarks by my colleague Paul O'Kane. She didn't. She encouraged members to look in detail at the figures. I have. Data published only this afternoon by Public Health Scotland makes clear that only 60.5% of contact tracing was completed within the target 72 hours, well below the WHO standard. These are finalised figures, Presiding Officer. The First Minister herself stressed the importance of accuracy. Presiding Officer, I know you want colleagues to treat each other with respect. That applies to the First Minister too. Out of respect for colleagues, should the First Minister apologise to the Chamber for suggesting figures were being used in a misleading way by members of this Chamber? And will the First Minister be asked to clarify the record at the earliest opportunity?
I thank the member for advance notice of his point of order. The content of members' contributions is not a matter for me. However, the member's point is now on the record. And if any member realises that he or she has given incorrect information in a contribution in the chamber, there is a procedure for addressing this via the official report. Now, there are three questions to be put as a result of today's business. I propose to ask a single question on 7 Parliamentary Bureau motions, and if any member objects, please say so now.
Yes.
Thank you. Can I ask to which motion the member objects?
Motion 1120, Presiding Officer.
Can I, Mr Kerr, can I confirm?
Yes, 1120 as well.
Thank you. In that case, I will put the others on block and take that question separately. So the first question is that motions 1113, 1114, 1115 and 1117 to 1119, in the name of George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, on approval of SSIs be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 1120 in the name of George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, on approval of SSIs be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension. The question is that motion 1120 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on approval of an SSI be agreed. Members may cast their votes now. The vote is now closed. The result of the vote on motion 1120 in the name of George Adam is yes 67, no 25. There were 24 abstentions. The motion is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 1121 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on committee membership be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The final question is that motion 1122, in the name of George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, on substitution on committees be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed, and that concludes decision time. And we'll now move to members' business, and I would be grateful if members leaving the chamber could do so quietly.